What we want to see and what we're looking to see is, what is the cognitive impact of CrossFit on people? Does it help them focus better? Does it help them think more clearly? Does it actually improve the function of their brain? And what better people to work with than teachers?
It really begs the question, what would happen if we take these 18 teachers, administrators, and put them into a box and let them experience it?
I really want to expose them to as many different workouts as I can. I want them to think about, what can I do with my class?
Can we turn on that light, like, yeah, that might be important to teach our students?
Oh, absolutely. I think it should be, you know, a beacon of light.
You can't force this team building or these bonding exercises, but you put them through CrossFit and it's amazing how close these people are going to get to each other.
Teachers need to take control of their health and fitness so they can be better role models for their students. This is our audience. This is who we're in front of for 8 hours a day.
They're going to see their lives changed.
Propylene glycol alginate.
Sodium alginate. What the heck is that?
Sodium benzoate, potassium metabisulfate.
Modified food starch. Something sounds wrong about that.
Propellant, nitrous oxide, mono and diglycerides.
Did you say propellant?
Propellant. Yep, propellant.
Throw that out.
I know it's not paleo approved, paleo friendly in there.
We'll go through it.
Tightens your awareness, for sure. You know, rethinking snacks and rethinking meals and lunchbox lunches for my kids. I'm not going to put them on it 100% like I'm going to try to do, but I will be making changes in their lunches and their meals.
Does it surprise you to see that all this stuff technically is not... It is either something processed.
Yes, it surprised me because we are trying to eat healthy, but I guess we are not looking very carefully at the ingredients.
When we come back, the next time we visit?
Fruits, veggies, lean meats, healthy fats.
Yes, I got inspired and I really want to start doing it, trying to eat healthy. And
So where did you find a recipe?
Well, I modified it a little bit. It was in the book that I have, Paleo, for Living Paleo for Dummies.
Awesome.
It's simple.
Was that legit?
They're finding that their bodies are changing. They're getting push-ups now. One girl just realized that she's faster running.
I ran a mile in under 9 minutes the other day, and I've never done that.
Ever?
Ever.
So 3 months, we added another month in. They started the Paleo Challenge about 4 weeks ago. Out of the 17 to 18 that started, about 10 or 11 that are still pretty consistent. And out of that 10 or 11, I would say 7 are doing the Paleo Challenge, maybe 6.
You don't want to do the challenge.
I didn't want to do it. I will support them with all I've got. I won't tempt them. I'll be supportive of them, but it wasn't for me.
So didn't even think about it?
No.
Joy's got her mind made up. There is no paleo challenge. There is no change. And that's one of those things where I'm not going to argue with her or try and discourage her. She's in here. We'll take what we can get, you know. 2 months ago, she would be running. Now she's running the whole way in. What's the relation here? What's going on?
It's my younger sister.
This is your daughter?
Yeah.
Doing CrossFit with my mom.
How did you end up being here? Did your mom say, do you want to come, or did you say, can I go?
I asked if I could go because we had a half day today at school.
Really good. But here's the difference. If we catch this and I'm here with my back rounded, I'm gonna have a really hard time standing up, right? So when I catch it, if my elbows are up here, now my chest is vertical, now all I gotta do is stand. So when we catch, I wanna be as vertical as I can, and that's gonna be my elbows getting up. All right, ready?
Bend down a little bit. Yeah.
Go! What's new, Scooby-Doo?
Same old. I've missed no classes. I had a cold and I missed one, so.
So your attendance record has been pretty outstanding.
If I do say so myself.
From the very first day one, you seem to have the most difficult time connecting or disconnecting.
I did say that.
And so you must be proud of yourself.
I'm very proud of myself.
You said you might think about the modifying of nutrition. Did you do anything different?
I would say that I started this week because restaurant week was over last week. Full disclosure.
What's restaurant week?
it's Queen City Restaurant Week, where all the best restaurants have a discounted menu.
I lost 8 pounds already. I'm so excited.
It's a big deal.
And I have cheated a little bit, but nothing huge and no candy. Because if it's a downward spiral. If I have one candy, that's it.
When we spoke to you at the nutrition challenge, you said you were...
I was scared. Really scared. And now it's like I'm making better choices. I'm like totally at home. It's all paleo all the time. But when I go out, I still, yeah, I just make better choices. So it's not as hard as I thought it was going to be.
But it's going great. I've only cheated once. So.
What was your cheat?
I had a chocolate oatmeal, one of those no-bake chocolate oatmeal cookies. But I was at a family gathering.
We're in week 4 and we're going for 6 weeks. So it's been hard, I'm not going to lie. It's definitely been hard.
We were in your kitchen, just cleaned out some stuff.
Yeah, we were in the kitchen, we cleaned out some stuff. My kitchen looks different.
Just planned ahead a lot. So I kind of know what's for breakfast, what's for lunch, and what's for dinner. And it's really helped me realize what I'm eating. And then it's planned out so I won't cheat.
Vegetables. I don't eat enough vegetables, and I have to. I'm decided that I'm going to eat more vegetables. Because Steve's making us do this paleo challenge.
Is will you work out and do good exercise?
And do you like it? Do you like what you see?
Yeah.
You think you'll do it someday?
Yes.
15 minutes AMRAP of thrusters and slam balls with a run. So there's workouts that they wouldn't have been able to finish a third of the workout the first couple weeks they were here, and now they're finishing it, but it's crushing them. So, you know, they, in their mind, no matter how many times I tell them, this is amazing you guys are able to do this, they still see, I'm still catching my breath for 10 minutes after the workout on my back, so I must not be getting better. But they're getting amazingly better because I'm making the workouts a lot harder.
Would you be a better teacher in the classroom if you were fitter, healthier?
I mean, I think to a certain degree, yes, because like, you want to try to have a classroom that's not just like traditional lecture style where you're just standing and they're sitting. So like, the more energy you have to deal with like 20 kids for four or five periods a day, I think the better. So I feel more energized when I exercise on a regular basis.
And that's huge because I teach 4 and 5 year olds, so the energy that I have is so much better. My kids feel it, I feel it. I mean, we just get a lot more accomplished, I'm not as tired. It's just a good thing. It's a really good thing.
What impact does it have just those kids watching their parents right there?
They're going to see that they're setting the example. They're the role models
for
what they're growing up to be or what they can do. So when it becomes a habit, you know, developing that habit at a young age, it'll stick with them all through school.
Yay!
What is CrossFit?
Oh, it's really tiring, but fun.
I want my boys to know that that a healthy lifestyle is an active lifestyle, and it's making good choices and involving yourself with good people. That
I think it's different
the way like we are doing it. I think like doing it anywhere else has a different meaning than like doing it together here.
It's hard work. It's discipline, but it's good.
CrossFit is a big scary man, former Marine, who you come to the gym and he kicks your butt for an hour and you kick and scream and complain, and then you come back asking for more.